Hey everybody, this is Automator MC, and I'm going to do a tutorial on how to build a squid farm. Now, I haven't built this yet, but I'm fairly certain the idea is going to work. And first of all, at F3, squid spawn between Y45 and 63, and right now I am at Y70, so there's no danger of squids spawning in any surface water around the area. But we will have to clear bodies of water that are underground, and we'll do that as part two. But in part one here, this area, we are not surrounded by any large bodies of water for a pretty good distance in every direction. I'm going to make this 3x3. Now, it goes without saying that the bigger you make this, the faster the spawn rate, but it's squids, so we're not that worried about it. And I'm going to start off here by making an access to the bottom to get back out again. And so we're going to go down to the very bottom spawn area, which is Y45. And here at Y45, I'm just going to carve a path so I can find the bottom when I dig the other hole. And I'm going to go down, I'm going to leave the floor there, and then I'm going to come down below it. This is where I'm going to put my hoppers. And this will be my tunnel to get back out again. So let me just set this up. Well, first of all, since I only brought two buckets with me, I'm going to set up an infant water supply here. And this will be the water break to get down here quickly. And it will no longer need this down here. And then I'm going to build my access back to the surface. That was pretty dark, but we made it to the top. So now we got a quick way down, quick way back up. We have company. I don't see him though. I think the dog handled him. Now, this we're going to dig all the way down to the lowest point that they can spawn at, 45, which it already is marked down below. So here we are for now. Let's go ahead and put the hoppers in. And I think I'll have the chest. Really doesn't matter exactly where it goes, as long as all the hoppers face towards it. There'll be no reason to come in here, so I'll put it right here at the opening. Thank you. Now you may have noticed that these are one below their lowest spawn point, but they won't be able to spawn there anyway because there will be no water there. We're going to put signs up here. And this is going to be where they suffocate. So there is the easy part. We'll just seal it up. Now we are above 63 here, but that's okay. A little bit of extra water isn't going to hurt anything. Now I'm going to fill this in. I'll need infinite water again. And that should be it for the buckets. And then we just open up the bottom, and now we have a nice area for the squids to spawn in. Next thing, phase two, we need to get away a little bit, and we need to find the water sources that are going to be a problem. So we're going to build an x-ray machine here. And take a look around. We can see our trap is already full of squids. And they're at the bottom, and I wonder if we can see their suffocation damage. There we go. They're starting to flash now. So I can see right away there's going to be a problem area. Water is within the spawning range. And it looks like one right there is going to also be a problem. That one might be far enough away. Well, let's hit that one first. I can kind of make a pretty good judge. It's right to the left of this surface water here. And let's give that a shot, clearing that out. First things first, I am always playing on hard difficulty and survival. Okay, looking for a body of surface water. And Y is still on, so we can double check from in the water here. We are at 69, and they cannot spawn above 63, so we have nothing to worry about there. Now it was just, I think, right about here, just to the left of that body of water I said. So let's just dig down and see if we find it. Hopefully I won't find lava. Oh, there we are. So I'm gonna fill all this in with dirt. And then I'll torch it up, just in case I ever want to clear the caves in this area. And then I'm going to build my way back out. And as you can see there, I count 6 squids in there right now. Nope, 6, 7? Possibly 8. And you can see over here the area we just cleared. Now I can return back down to that area, I can see water I did not notice before. There's water. If I come back just this way and a little bit to the right as I'm facing this way, I'll find another body of water. And then if I go straight that way and down, I'll find that body of water. And there's another one over there. Let's see if we can find that one. And I'll take a shot at that one, and then I'll clear the rest of them later. That's pretty much the end of the tutorial. This is your functioning squid farm. And we have already 26, plus some dirt, 26 ink sacs in there. I got lucky with that other one, then I hit it immediately. But I might not get so lucky with this one. If I don't, I will show you how you track it down. Now, I think we were somewhere around here. Okay, I think I've gone deep enough, and I haven't found it, so what I'm going to do is build another X-ray machine exactly where I am. Oops, took a little damage there. And let's see if we can find that water. There's some down there. Is that the one we were looking for? Oh, right here, right straight in front of us. If I go straight that way, I can't miss it. Perhaps up a little bit. And here's another cave. I will go ahead and finish this up. But I guess that concludes the tutorial, and I hope you enjoy your squid farm.